Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video I am going to describe and demonstrate about the electro-pneumatic trainer from Tesca. So this is a manual type of electro-pneumatic trainer, electrical based, and in which we are now going to introduce the different components used in the pneumatics, electro-pneumatic purposes in an industrial area. And pneumatics are far more older than any other equipments used in the industrial purposes to use air as a power source to moving and applying the movement of any machineries and different types of manner. So in this electro-pneumatic component trainer we will describe some of the basic electro-pneumatic components like double acting cylinder, single acting cylinder, and how they work with the electrical circuitry. So all the description and experiment will be covered in this video. So we are going to start with the different explanation of all the components which are included with this kit. So the order code for this electro-pneumatic system teaching modules is 52106 from Tesca. You can visit our website and inquiry about this order code using 52106. So now we are going to describe all the components which are included on this front panel. So this is a aluminium sheet applied on an inclined surface in which all the electro-pneumatic components are fixed, and this is a fixed component trainer. So we are going to start with all the components. So first, which this is the double acting cylinder. This is the tie rod model of double acting cylinder in which we can move the cylinder in both direction by using the air as a supply for the input power. So when air is incoming from this and the cylinder goes forward, and when the air is incoming from this end the cylinder goes reverse movement. So these are the different movements for the cylinder, and the tie rod model are used for the heavy duty uses in which the cylinder goes has the supports and this cylinder have a 100 mm stroke for working. Now moving on to the second component, which is also a double acting cylinder, and same working is also provided with this cylinder, but in this is a crimping type model, and in which this can be used as a low duty and the small components moving and the small or the low type of amount force is required. Now moving on, the next component is the single acting cylinder, in which this is a spring return single acting cylinder. The basic working of this type of cylinder is the when we provide the supply from the back end of the cylinder, this moves the forward, and the spring, because it is a spring return cylinder, the spring pulls back the piston when the air supply or the force is removed. So this is how we move this single acting cylinder. Moving on, we have flow control valves for each of cylinder, five flow control valves. In this we can control the flow of air, by which we can control the movement of cylinder as well. By controlling the flow, you can use this flow control valve to controlling the flow of air, and then the power also will be controlled. This is how the speed will be controlled of the movement of piston forward and backward. Now moving on, the actuators for these cylinders and the movement will be operated with this solenoid valves. These are the double coil solenoid valves, 5x2 solenoid valve. In this there are one inlet. This is the input line for this solenoid valve, which is a 5x2 input line, and these are the A and B output lines of this solenoid valve. These will be connected with any of the cylinder requirement as per the requirement, and these are the two outlet line. So total is the five lines and the five sections for this valve, and this is out, and the two of them are the exhaust line and three of them are the input and the output lines. So this is why we call this the 5x2 solenoid valve, and in which all the actuations will be operated with this 24 volt DC solenoid coil. This will pulls the plunger when it is operated. So when this side of the coil operated, the first movement or the forward and reverse movement, one of the movement from forward and reverse will be operated, and then when we operate the other coil, the other movement, the opposite movement will be operated with this type of this type of solenoid valve. Now moving on, this is the 3x2 single solenoid valve in which the this is the spring return single solenoid valve in which when we provide supply to this coil solenoid coil the input line will be provided on this section and the output line will be taken from this vent and this has a one exhaust vent so this is why this is called the 3x2 solenoid valve in which all there are three vents and in which two are the used and one is the exhaust so this is the 3x2 solenoid valve and this is the spring return 3x2 solenoid valve when the supply is provided the actuation and the line will be passed through and when the supply is removed the valve will be automatically returned and closed by the spring inside it moving on this is the 5x2 solenoid valve again but this is also a spring return 5x2 solenoid valve the same function will of the 5x2 solenoid valve will be happen with this when we provide the supply on this coil but when we remove the supply will on this coil the opposite action of the piston and the cylinder will be happen accordingly we do not provide any other coil for this type of solenoid valve now moving on this is also a 5x2 solenoid valve same functions for the second double acting cylinder that we are going to use in this section moving on this is the manifold with the slide valve here so the incoming line from the air supply will be provided on this section and these are the different junction boxes and this is the junction box of or the junction or the manifold in which when we provide and connect any of the PU tube with this any of the section or any of the point the valve will be automatically on otherwise when we do not connect any of the point this will be in the closed position and this is the valve slide valve which will on the incoming supply to the manifold now moving on this is the lubrication regulator and filter unit in this the filter lubrication and regulator are provided so this is the regulator to regulate the power supply accordingly pressure with the pressure gauge with pressure gauge also provided for this line this LPR unit and in this is the incoming line and you have to provide the incoming source from the air compressor and you can also see there is a direction shown on the front side so this is the direction this will show the how the air will be incoming from this LPR unit so we going to connect the incoming compressor supply on this port and from one of the port these are right now connected with the stoppers and one of the port will be open and this will be connected with the manifold supply in the further operations and you can regulate the supply to adjust the pressure as per accordingly our experiments now we are also providing some magnetic sensors on the piston rods so these need to be adjusted as per the piston movement and this will be operated when the piston is beneath the inside the casing of the cylinder so when the piston is inside at this below this sensor this will be operated and this will give the signal to our any other electrical components and when the piston is at the forward movement this will operate this sensor and this magnetic sensor will be operated and the output movement will be given as the signal and these are the cables which are already connected sensor cables on with the all the sensor provided with all cylinders and the coil operation or the coil power cables to power the coils from 24 volt power supply the coils are also provided with internally connected sections so these are the connectors that has been connected with all the solenoid valves and sensors provided now moving on to our junction boxes in this we are going to start with this first push button module in which when we provide the 24 volt supply from the SMPS we will has input the 24 volt power supply and this can be connected to further and these are the three anode switches here this will be used to going to use the operations to actuate all the cylinders and the terminals from all the NO and NC terminals are provided similarly the indications light are also provided when we provide 24 volt to any of this section this will be in lighting with the pilot lamps on inside the push buttons, and this is the stop type switch button switch, in which when we press this button inside, the switch will be operated, and when we remove the release the switch, this will be in non-operating condition. Moving on, there are two relay modules in which consisting the four pole relay, three relay in each of the module, and this relay will be operated with 24 volt power supply. These are the coil connections of the relay, and these are the common connections, and these are NO and NC points of the relay. So both of two modules have same working, and as per the requirement we will introduce more and more relays as a requirement. So we are also providing a switch mode power supply of 24 volt DC with 4 ampere power supply. The input will be connected with this power cord to any of the 220 volt power supply source, and this is the on off switch here. This will on the power supply, and the 0 volts and the plus 24 volt will be outgoing from these terminals. So we are required the 24 volt supply for all the operations in this cylinder type. So this is the power supply from Tesca to use in this 24 volt power supply section. And these are some accessories like PU tubes, some solenoid valves or the actuating pumps, and some PU fittings from T and the Y sections, and a cutter for cutting the PU tube as per the requirement, and some patch cords from different sizes to used as per the connection, and some hand tools. These are the stoppers as required to stop any of the vent when working with. These are also going to use, and these are some hand tools to connect the sensors and the other accessories to the sensors and tighten the proper arrangement. Moving on, we are also offering a user manual consisting all the electronumatics explanation, descriptions and the experiment and exercises from these different components of electronumatic trainer. So this is complete setup, and also a chart including for the explaining the different workings of electronumatic components. Four different types of charts for educational purpose are also introduced with this kit. So in the user manual, the first section has the basic educational information. In this, information about all the training kits and the pneumatic systems are provided, and the second section will consist the training and the exercise book. So we are going to perform the exercises. You have to read all the first section instructions to use when working with the electronumatic trainer kit, and now we are going to perform the exercises. Some of the exercises will be explained in this video for your ease of operation, and we will start with the first exercise, which is the operation of a single acting cylinder using single solenoid valve, direct actuation of the solenoid valve. So this is the basic pneumatic diagram, in which I am also going to explain the pneumatic diagram, how we connect the all pneumatic sections, and in which we will use the single acting cylinder with a 5x2 spring return solenoid valve and manifold and the slide valve, and also the FRCLM with pressure gauge unit. And this is the basic push button and the solenoid valve section. In this, the basic diagram of electrical circuit is also provided. So we are going to perform and build the circuit of pneumatic diagram, and then electrical diagram, electrical circuit as well, and then we operate the single acting cylinder. So we are first going to build the pneumatic section. For this, we will start first the compressor incoming line. So this is the incoming line from the compressor from the A unit, and we will connect this to the FRL unit here, and we will on the valve. Before that, we will remove the stopper from here and connect a piece of PU tube of 8 mm to this section. So now the other end of this FRL unit will be connected with the manifold input line or with the slide valve. Now we will connect the any of point from this section to, we are going to use the 5x2 solenoid valve. For this we have to use, so we will connect a 4 mm PU tube to this junction box, and this will be connected with 5x2 spring return solenoid valve. Now for output of this solenoid valve, the one output from the solenoid valve will be connected with single acting cylinder like this. So while working with this PU fittings, when you want to remove this section, this has a shark pin inside this, and you have to press this PU fitting like this inside, and this will be easily removed the PU tube from this. And when we connect this PU tube to the line, just put this inside and this will be connected properly. But do not apply excess pressure to pull out the tubes, this will damage the PU fittings as well. Now as described in the pneumatic diagram, so we have connected one output from the flow control valve. Sorry, we first use this to the flow control valve, and we will connect another PU tube from the output of the flow control valve, and this will be connected with the cylinder. So we have at the flow control valve the in the line of the single acting cylinder. Now at this is the outgoing line from this diagram you can see, and the other end of the 5x2 solenoid valve, these are the exhaust section beside the solenoid valve that I have explained earlier, and this is the spring return solenoid valve also. We have to connect and block the output using a stopper. Stoppers are also provided in the accessories, and this stopper will block the other output of the solenoid valve. So we will connect the stopper from on this PU fitting like this, and this stopper will block the output. So we will only require the one actuation for single acting cylinder using the 5x2 solenoid valve. So this is the pneumatic circuitry completed right now, and now we are going to build the electrical circuit to operate this. So we are going to first introduce the power supply, 24 volt power supply, which is required to operate the solenoid valve. So 220 volt source has already connected in this power supply, and now we are going to on this power switch, and the 24 volt DC power supply will be connected with this patch cords. So the negative or 0 volt will be connected to the 0 volt supply, and 24 volt will be connected with 24 volt supply. So 24 volt DC will be provided to this junction box of the push button module. Now we are going to build the circuit for operations and actuations. So the basic circuit is that the 24 volt power supply will be first connect to the NO of any PB that we are required, and the other end of this PB will be going to the point of solenoid valve, and the other end of solenoid valve will be going to the 0 volt section. So we required a one patch code, and 24 volt will be connected to the PB with this patch code here. So 24 volt will be provided to any of the push button NO section. For this we are going to connect the 13 number pin. Now this is the connector from the solenoid valve coil here. So this is the positive and negative of the solenoid valve. So we have to provide the 24 volt supply on these terminals to operate the section. Now the other end of the NO of the push button will be connected with this, and the output or the other end of negative of the coil will be connected with the 0 volt. So this is our electrical connections has been done. Before doing and operating the cylinders, make sure the valve of the compressor and the incoming line will be on, and the pressure should be in the 50 to 60 psi, and this will be enough to operate the cylinders. So for enlighting the lamp of the push button, we will connect the indication terminals. The one terminal will be connected with the output or the NO terminal, which is connected with the coils. So when the coil is operated, the indication also provided on the push button, and the other end need to provide the ground supply. So when we press the button, the lamp of the push button will be enlightened, and the operation will be also shows by the indications. Now we will put on the pressure by opening the valve of pressure compressor and here we can see the pressure, as the pressure gauge is showing at 75 psi on the pressure gauge. You can control the pressure by this regulator, pressure regulator. So by moving this pressure regulator, you can increase or decrease the pressure as per the requirement. And this has the lock system also. So when we press this knob downside downwards, so this will be locked, and when we upside the knob, this will be in the rotation. So right now, as I decreasing the pressure clockwise, the pressure is decreased, and when we move this knob on the anticlockwise, the pressure will be increased. So that's how the pressure regulators work. Now we will verify our connection that we have verified. Now we will operate the sections. First we will on the slide wall here. This will on the incoming line to the 5x2 spring return solenoid valve, and now we will actuate the push button to operate this. So we will on the slide valve downwards and operate the coil with operating this push button. So as I operate this push button, the forward movement operates till I press the input push button, and as I release the push button, the backward cycle will operate. So this is the forward movement and this is the backward movement of single acting spring return cylinder through a 5x2 solenoid coil using flow control valve. So the flow will be controlled by increasing and tighten and loosening the flow control valve section. So as I increase and open the flow control valve, so the air release will be happen more excessive amount, and this will return the pressure slightly. So the input from the cylinder, we can control only the input cycle. The output cycle will remain on and on because the only air vent is provided. So the incoming and the forward movement will be controlled with this flow control valve, as the flow control valve will be only at the forward movement section. So as I increase and operate the pressure, flow pressure will be increased. Here you can see the forward movement speed is increased, and as I decrease the and close the flow control valve, the air incoming will be decreased, and this will decrease the forward movement of piston here. Here you can see as I decreasing the flow of air by closing the flow control valve, here you can see the complete amount of air will be closed. So this is how the flow control valve works. So now we move on to the second exercise, which is the operation of a double acting cylinder using single solenoid valve. In this, we are also using the same solenoid valve that we have used last practical, and instead of using a single acting cylinder spring return cylinder, we will use a double acting cylinder with two flow control valves. And in the last practical, we have blocked the second output of the solenoid valve, but in this section we will use the second output. This will be connected for the reverse movement of the double acting cylinder. The electrical circuitry will remain same and rest of the connections will same, just need to change the double acting cylinder instead of single acting cylinder and a pneumatic line for the second output of solenoid valve. So we will extend this connections by using a PU tube. So PU tube will be connected to the double acting cylinders. Now we will remove the connections first before closing and opening the pneumatic sections. Close the slide valve. As I close the slide valve, moving this slide to the upwards, and this will close all the pneumatic sections. So now we will remove the carefully PU tubes from the flow control valves, and this will be connected to the double acting cylinder. So we will using the crimping type double acting cylinder for this purpose, slightly on the flow control valves, so some of amount will be present to operate the double acting cylinders. Now we will connect the back side for the forward movement, and the other end will be, so now we will remove the stopper from this and we will connect this section, the other line or other end of the 3x2, 5x2 solenoid valve, spring return solenoid valve, to the flow control valve, and we required another piece of PU tube to connect the forward or the reverse movement of the double acting cylinder. So the basic electrical circuitry in this pneumatic diagram is done. Electrical circuitry will be remain same for as per the last practical, just we have to operate and actuate the solenoid valve to operate this. Now properly check the pneumatic circuitry from the circuit diagram given in the user manual. Now we will on the slide valve and operate the cylinder by using this push button. Here you can see, as I press the push button, the forward movements will happen of the piston, and as I release the push button, the reverse movement will be happen. So this is the direct actuating of the double acting cylinder. So the flow control also will be can seen very carefully and frequently, because the outgoing and incoming lines will depends on in the double acting cylinder to controlling will be more accurate. So as I close the flow control valves incoming line here, so this will decrease the speed of piston flow, and as I open the flow control valves some more, like this. So you can see the speed is slightly increase of the forward and reverse movement of the double acting cylinder. So that's how we working with the single acting cylinder and the double acting cylinder in the direct actuation mode. Now we are going to perform the operation of a double acting cylinder using single solenoid valve, but in this case we will use a relay for solenoid actuation. In the earlier practical we will direct operate the solenoid valve using a push button, but in this case we will use a relay. So the circuit and the pneumatic diagram will be remain same as the last practical for the double acting cylinder that we have performed, but the electrical circuit will slightly change. In this we will include the relay. So by push button we will first operate the relay, and then the relay will operate the solenoid valve. So how we use the relay in the actuation and the actuation of the circuitry will be controlled. So we will make the circuit diagram as described in the user manual. So as the first relay lateral logic, the 24 volt will be going to the push button 1 and other 24 volt will be going to the relay 1. So this is the coil, this coil will be operated with the push button, and the NO of the relay will be provided 24 volt. So the common will be connected with the NO, and when the relay is actuated, the NO will going to NC, and this NC will be close the solenoid valve. So we are going to perform the section. For this we will connect the 24 volt supply to the push button NO, and the other end of this push button will continually forward the 24 volt to the coil of a relay. Here we will use the relay 3 for this section, and the output of the relay and the other end of this relay will be connected with the negative supply or the 0 volt supply of the 24 volts. Now the NO of the relay will provide it to 24 volt, so 24 volt will be provided to the NO. So we are going to use the 11 number terminal, which is the common. So 11, 21, 31 and 41 are the common terminals here. and 14, 24, 34 and 44 are the NO terminals. Similarly, 12, 22, 32 and 42 are the NC terminals. So these are the normally open terminals, these are the normally connected terminals, and this is the common terminal that we have to provide the 24 volt and any other supply we required. So the common will be provided on the 11 number terminal, and the solenoid valve will be operated. So we will connect the solenoid valve to the NO of this relay. The one pole of this relay's NO is connected from this, and we will connect the 0 volt to the negative. Sorry, the negative will be provided here. So we will connect it here, and our solenoid valve connections has been done, and relay connections are also done. Now we will verify our circuit, and then we operate the double acting cylinder using relay mode. Now for indication of the push button, the positive will be connected to the indication and negative will be connected with the negative supply. So when we press the push button, the indication will show that the push button is operating the relay, and this relay will be operate the solenoid valve. So our circuit has been verified. Now we will operate the pneumatic circuit will be remain same. So we do not make any change in the pneumatic circuit as the last two practicals. So now just change the electrical circuit to operate the solenoid valve using a relay. So we will press the push button. Here you can see, as I press the push button will operate the relay. 24 volt will be operating by the coil, and common, as we had already provided the 24 volt on the common of the relay, and this common will be the NO, and NO will be operated as NC when we operate the coil, and the coil will operate the cylinder. So solenoid valve will be connected to the NO of the relay. So as I press the push button, the relay operates, and the forward movement of the cylinder piston will be happen. And as I remove the supply from the coil, the relay will unactuated, and this will unactuate the solenoid valve as well, and the reverse movement also happens. So this is how we control the solenoid valves using a relay. Now we are going to apply AND logic using two manual controls for forward stroke of a double acting cylinder. The direct actuation of solenoid valve will be happen with this. So this is the basic electrical circuit of AND logic using. In this we will use the two PB when AND logic represents when both the inputs are high or the one, the output will be on. In case any of the input is zero or not on, will be the output will not be on. So this is the basic circuitry we are going to use and make. The double acting pneumatic cylinder circuit diagram of the pneumatic circuit is remain same. So I am just explaining the electrical diagram for this. So we are going to use the PB. So for this, the 24 volt supply will be first going to the PB1 here. So for this we are going to use these both two PBs. So we will connect the normally open contact of the PV, and the other end of this PV will be going to the other contact of the PV, and the solenoid valve for the double acting cylinder will be connected with the this end of this PV. So when both the input will be high, the output or the 24 volt supply will be provided to the solenoid valve. Now the negative will be connected with the negative of the solenoid valve. So this is the basic circuitry of AND gate. Now we will verify the circuit and operate the cylinders. For enlighting the push button terminals, we will connect the positive to the push button coil, and negative will be connected in common, and this will be going to the 0 volts. Also for the first PB, we will connect the number 14 terminal to the indication terminals of the PB. Now we will operate the push buttons one by one. So right now we have input the 00 on both the inputs. Right now no operations has been happened. Now as I provide 0 and 1, there is also no operations, and when we provide 0 here and 1 here, this will also not connecting any of the circuitry because the 24 volt supply is not going to the further by this circuit, and when we press both the inputs, this will operate the forward movement of the double acting cylinder. So this is how we perform the AND gate logic here. We have to only provide any of the sections for proper incoming. You just need to connect the supply to the 24 volt, so both the terminals will be enlightened. So this is how we connect the and use the and explain applying the AND logic for the solenoid valve. So these are the logics which are more commonly used in the operations in industrial purposes. Now we are going to apply all logic using two manual controls for forward stroke of a double acting cylinder using a direct actuation of the solenoid valve. So circuit diagram or the pneumatic diagram will be remain same. Need to change the electrical circuitry in which we will connect two push buttons in the parallel. This represent the old circuit or all logic of the push buttons, and this will operate the solenoid valve. So we will going to make the old logic circuitry. For this, the 24 volt supply will be first connect to 13 number terminal of any of the push button, and similarly supply parallel 24 volt will also connect to the other push button, the PB2, and the outputs of both the PB will be common, and this will be connected with the output of solenoid valve. So when any of the output will going high, the output will be provided to the 24 volt solenoid valve coil, and negative will be connected with the negative. Now for enlighting the PBs, so we will connect the for with the 24 volt supply will going to both the indications. That's why we are not using the indications right now, because the indication will disturb your proper guidance to the old logic. So when we provide supply, this will be on both the indications. That's why we do not using the indications in this section. So now for old logic, both the inputs are right now zero, so there is no operations going, and when any of the operations will be on, the old logic will perform and the output will be on. So we are going to use the first PB. This will operating the piston of or the solenoid valve, and when we operate the other PB, this will also operating the piston. So this is the 10 and 01 operation, and when we operate both the sections, this will also operate the cylinder. So output will high when any of the input will high. So now we are going to perform the continuous operation of a double acting cylinder using double solenoid valve. In this, we are going to use the magnetic sensor that we have explained in the earlier video. So these are the A0 and A1 sensor, also magnetic sensor. These are connected on the cylinders. So we are going to use these sensors to operate the continuous cycle. The circuitry of the pneumatic section will the same as described. Just we have introduced the double coil double solenoid valve, and this we use the S1 S2 two coils, and this is the electrical circuitry or the ladder relay ladder diagram are described. So we will do the connection as per this. Before that, we will make the pneumatic section and pneumatic connections as described in the user manual. So we are using the double solenoid valve. In this, two coils are operated for forward and reverse movement. We have to operate any of the coil for any of the movement. So we will connect the PU tubes for input, and the output will be connected to the first flow control valves. Here both the outputs will be going to the flow control valves, and the other end of this flow control valve will be connected with the input. Now for this tie rod model we have to introduce the quick release PU fitting or quick release valve. By this the quick release of the section will happen. So these are the two types of quick release valves will provided. You can use any of the valves for this section. So we are going to use this valve. This is the quick release fitting valve. So this will be connected like this. Just press this inside and this will connect. To remove this quick release valve, just pull this section beside and this will open the valve. And to insert the valve, just push this and this will lock itself inside. So we will connect the end to the quick release valve here and the further end also connected. Now we will do the electrical circuitry for the continuous operation. So this is the electrical circuit described in the user manual. For this we will use the PB. In this PB4 will be used. The PB4 is the direct operated NOPB or the NCPB which will on the sensor continuously. So the when we on the PB4, the continuous operation will be going and this will connect the sensor. The three terminals of the sensor will be like this connected. This is the input brown and the black will be output. The output will be operated the relay and relay's other end will be going to the 0 volt. And also the positive negative 24 volt supplies need to provide to the sensor. So positive will be going to the with the push button and negative will be directly connected to the 0 volt. Now as we operate the relay we have to provide the 24 volt on common of the relay and NO will be connected with the solenoid valve first for the double acting cylinder. So the common or NO will be operate the solenoid valve for the first solenoid valve. Now when the first solenoid valve and the forward movement of the piston happens, the A1 sensor as described in the pneumatic diagram will operate and this will give output to operate the relay 2. And when the relay 2 operate, the relay 2 operates will be operate the solenoid valve 2. And as the solenoid valve 2 operates, this will happens, this will actuate the reverse movement of the piston. And as the reverse movement of the piston happens, this will again operates the A0 sensor, and A0 sensor when operates, this will again operate the relay 1. So the cycle will continuously run till we remove the PB4 from the direct 24 volt supply provided to the sensor A0. So when the supply will cut off, the complete cycle will be also stopped. Now for electrical circuitry, we will first provide the 24 volt power supply to the PB4. So 24 volt will be connected to the NO of this PB. So this type of PB is directly actuated, continuous supply operation will be happen. Now at the other end of this PB we need to connect the brown terminal of the A0 sensor. So this is our A0 sensor here. So the terminals of this A0 sensor will be like this. So brown and blue are the positive and negative to the provide 24 volt for operation of the sensor, and black will be the output. This will operate the relay. So we will provide the 24 volt by connecting this brown terminal of the A0 sensor to the positive, and the output of this will be operated the relay here. So now we will further increase the 24 volt supply to the relay box. For this we will connect the positive with the positive 24 volt and negative with the negative or 0 volt. So the in this section or this block the 24 volt supply will also included, so we do not need to further reach the supply. So we need to provide the negative to the relay coil right now. So the negative will be provided to the this like this, and now we will use the NO of the relay 1 and this will operate the solenoid valve. So 24 volt supply will be provided to the 11 number terminal which is the common, and the solenoid valve. This is the S1 solenoid valve here. So we will considering the S1 solenoid valve this one and S2 solenoid valve this one. This is the sensor A2 here. This is the solenoid valve S1. This will be connected to the anode of the positive will be connected to the anode of the relay, and negative will be going to the 0 volt supply. So as the relay operates, the anode will going NC, and NC, as the NC happens, the 24 volt supply directly provided to the solenoid valve. So this is the first section of the relay. Now we will going to the for connection for the reverse movement. For this we will use the A1 sensor. The first sensor is A0 and the forward sensor is the A1. Now the A1 sensor will be operated directly, and the output will operate the relay 2. So we have to provide the 24 volt supply to this A1 sensor. So the positive and negative will be connected with the 24 volt supply here, the positive and negative. So we have directly provided the power supply to this, and now we will operate the output of this sensor will operate the relay 2 here. So we have to provide the negative as well to this coil. So negative will be provided, we can provide negative from here also. And for the anode of this relay 2 will operate the solenoid valve. So we will provide the 24 volt to the anode or the common of this relay, and now we will connect the second solenoid valve S2 with the 14 number pin of the relay. So the positive, when the relay 2 operates, the positive will be provided to the solenoid valve directly, and negative will be connected to the negative. Now this is the complete electrical circuitry that has been done. We will verify our connections again with the complete setup described in the user manual, and then we operate the cycle of the multi-cycle operation of double acting cylinder. So we have verified our connections. Now for indication of the this red continuous actuated PB, we will provide the 24 volt from the sensor terminal to the indication terminal, and the negative will be connected with the negative or 0 volt of this sensor. Now as I on this this button, this is the continuously operated switch. So as I operate this, the continuous supply to the A0 sensor will be provided, and the continuous multi-cycle operation will be ongoing happens as I described earlier with the circuit diagram. So now I will on the circuit. Now as the forward movement completes, this will continuously operate the double acting cylinder, and this is the continuous cycle of the double acting cylinder is ongoing. Now for controlling the flow, we will change and control the flow of the carefully and slowly. So the continuous cycle operation will also control the flow, so we can control the frequency and speed of the cylinder like this. So you can see the cylinder speed is very decreased. Now as I open the flow control valves, the air inlet will increase, airflow will increase, and we can control any of the direction, either forward and backward, to controlling the movement. Here you can see the forward movement, it has the slow speed, and the reverse movement is at the higher speed. Now we will increase the flow, so the forward and reverse movement will both on the same speed. So by using flow control valve, you can control the speed of actuation or the forward and reverse movement of the piston as well. So this is how we control the double acting cylinder in a multi-cycle operation using magnetic sensors, relays, and air control or the control circuitry. So this is the continuous cycle operation. This will stop when we pull off the supply from the A0 sensor by removing this switch, and again when we operate this switch, the continuous cycle will operate it continuously. Now for the last operation, this is the two double acting cylinder
are to be operated electronumatically in this sequence. In this you perform the sequence A plus B plus A minus and B minus. I will explain you what is the A plus B plus and A minus B minus are the sequence, but before that we will describe the pneumatic circuit in which we are using two double acting cylinder that we have provided on this kit, and two flow control valves and two double solenoid coils, so double solenoid valve in which. So we are going to use four sensors, A0, A1, B0, B1, four solenoid coils, S1, S2, S3 and S4, and remaining section for FRL unit and slide wall manifolds are required. And this is the electrical diagram, electrical circuitry or later relay logic here provided. So in this we will first provide the PB4, which is as I described in the earlier practical, and this PB4 will be operate the PB1, and this PB1 will operate the B0 sensor. This is the B0 sensor of second solenoid valve, and the forward movement will be represent the A plus for the A cylinder, and forward movement of the B cylinder will be represent the B plus. So B plus, A plus are the forward movement of both the cylinder, and A minus are the reverse, A minus and B minus are the reverse movements of the piston for both the cylinders respectively. Now explaining the relay later logic diagram, this is the B0 sensor. The B0 sensor will provide the supply with the PB1, and B0 sensor operates the relay 1. So when the B0 sensor operates, the relay 1 operates. The relay 1 now will continuously operate the solenoid valve 1. The solenoid valve will operate the forward movement of this cylinder, A cylinder, the A plus movement. And when the A plus movement happens and the piston reaches to the A1 sensor, so we have introduced the A1 sensor here. The A1 sensor will now operate the relay 2. The relay 2 will operate the solenoid coil 3. So the solenoid coil 3 will operate the forward movement of B0 cylinder. This will we have reached the B plus section. So A plus and B plus movements will be happened till this later logics. Now as the B0 sensor is already operated, when the piston of the B cylinder will reach the B1 sensor, the B1 sensor will now introduce, and this B1 sensor will operate the relay 3, and relay 3 will operate the solenoid coil 2. The solenoid coil 2 is connected with the backward movement of the A cylinder, and this will actuate the A minus cycle. So when the cylinder B1 sensor operates, this will give signals to operate the relay 2, and relay 2 will operate the solenoid coil 2, and solenoid coil 2 will operate the minus cycle, A minus cycle for the A cylinder. And when the A cylinder or A piston will reaches the A0, the A0 sensor is introduced in the later logic, and this will operate the relay 4, and relay 4 will operate the S4 cylinder. So the S4 solenoid coil will operate the reverse movement, which is the B minus we required in this sequence operation. So that's how the complete sequencing will operate by this later logic circuitry. Now we will first do the electronumatic pneumatic diagram. So the pneumatic diagram of one double acting cylinder is already done in the last practical, and now we'll in continuation extend the pneumatic diagram of the solenoid coil 2. So for solenoid coil 2, make sure the slide valve will in off position, and for giving the input to the solenoid valve 2, we will connect a PO tube here with the solenoid valve 2, and the first section will be connected with the forward. Make sure that you will use the same direction for the same coil. The meaning of this that for the plus movement of both the cylinders, we will use the left side coil for both the cylinders. For in this cylinder we have already connected the back
end of this cylinder with the left side coil, and the front end of this cylinder will be connected with the right side coil. So the movement or the directions will be remain, and the connections should be as the first and second cylinder should be in the same position. So you will not disturb the movements of forward and reverse of both the cylinders. Now for backward movement of this B cylinder, we will connect the right coil of the solenoid valve 2 to the forward end of this double acting cylinder. Now this is the pneumatic circuitry that has been done. Now we will going to the electrical circuitry to perform the electrical operation. Now for doing the electrical connections, we will start with the 24 volt supply. This will be connected with the continuous actuating signal. This is the PB4, and the output of this PB4 will be connected with PB1. We will using the PB1 here, and at this other end we will connect the B0 sensor. So in the cylinder, this is the B0, B1, and at the first section this is the A0, A1 sensor. So we will use the B0 sensors here. So this B0 magnetic sensor positive will be connected to the output of this push button, and negative will be connected to the negative, and the output of this magnetic sensor will operate the relay 1 here. Now we will connect the negative of this relay to the 0 volt supply, and we will provide a 24 volt supply to the common of this relay like this, and the solenoid valve 1 will be connected to output of this relay. So this is the solenoid valve 1, S1, S2, S3 and S4 for this exercise, and we will consider the solenoid valve S1. So S1 will be connected with this 14 number pin, and negative will be connected with the 0 volt supply. So this is the first solenoid operation connected. Now we will connect the A1 sensor. So the A1 sensor is this one. So we will connect the A1 sensor directly to the positive and negative of the 24 volt supply. So positive will be connected with positive. Anywhere you can connect the positive and negative. We need to provide the supply continuously to the sensor, and the output of this sensor will be connected to operate the relay 2. So this will be connected to the relay 2, and negative should be provided to the relay directly to operation. Now a 24 volt supply will also be provided. You can provide the 24 volt supply either from these connections and this. So I am using the other end. The 11 number common terminal will be connected with this 24 volt supply. Now this relay 2 will operate the solenoid coil 3 for the B plus operation. So this is our S3 as I described. So S3 will be connected with the output of this relay 2. So the positive or red terminal will be connected to the 14 number pin, and negative will be directly provided here. Now we are going to use the B1 sensor now. So the B1 sensor is this one for this cylinder. Now B1 sensor will be connected directly to the 24 volt supply. So I am connecting this to here. So the 24 volt positive will be connected here, and negative will be connected here, and the output of this B1 sensor will be going to the relay 3. So this is the relay 3 here. So coil will be connected here. You can connect any of this terminal. Now we will provide negative to this relay 3 here, and a phase for 24 volt supply will be provided on the 11th number terminal, and this will operate the solenoid coil 2. So this is the solenoid coil S2. So we need to connect the solenoid coil S2 to the 14 number NO terminal of the relay, and negative will be directly connected. Now for the last operation, which is the B minus, so we will now going to use the A0 sensor. The last sensor is A0 sensor here. So this is the A0 sensor. We need to provide the direct 24 volt supply to this sensor as well. So we will connect the positive to the 24 volt, negative to the negative, and this output will operate the relay 4. So in one block we have only have 3 relays. So now I'm going to use the last block here. So this will operate this last relay, relay 4, and negative we will provide this relay to the with this negative line. You can also extend the negative by using patch cords to this section as well. Now phase or 24 volt supply will also provided to the 11th number terminal of this relay, and this last relay will actuate the solenoid valve 4. So this is our solenoid valve 4. Valve 4 will be connected to the 14 number pin of this relay, and negative will be provided with this negative here. You can see right now the sensor is operated because the position of the sensor is at the back quadrant, and this was operate the solenoid coil as well. Now we will verify our connections, and then we operate the sequencing of the two cylinders. Now we have verified our connections. Now we will on the slide valve. This is the slide valve to provide the supply, and now first we will on the selection PB. So this PB is on. Now we are using and first provide the signal using this PB, and then we happens and see the A plus, B plus, then A minus, and then B minus operation or the sequencing will be happen. So as I press the button PB, here you can see A plus, B plus, then A minus, B minus. This is the complete operation sequencing. I have slowed down the operation by using the flow control valves, so you can observe the operation properly in both the cylinders. So flow control valves are the basic needs in pneumatic cylinders, so you can control the airflow as per the requirement and as per the operations. So again I will press the button. You can see A plus cycle, B plus, A minus, B minus. So this is the sequencing operation of A plus, B plus. Every time I push the button, the A plus, A, B plus, A minus, B minus sequence will continuously happens. So this is the sequencing operation will operates and use in many of the mechanical movements and industrial purposes. So that's how we use the all different circuitries of the electropneumatic circuits. And this is the user manual. In this, some of the exercises are more to do the proper practice with this 52106 electropneumatic system trainer. And this is the basic and from lower to the maximum size exercises that I have explained in this video. By using and referring these videos and these exercises, you can do all the exercises provided in this user manual. So while working with this kit, if you find any difficulties and explaining the sections and the understanding all the components of pneumatics, you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all the supports. Thank you.